time. To deal with forces that we want to arise to deal with us. If anybody tells you that in this life there are no battles to fight, the fellow is deceiving you. As a matter of fact, between the husband and the wife, there are battles to fight. Between brothers and brothers, there are battles to fight. Between sisters and sisters, there are battles to fight. Inside the church, there are battles to fight. Bishop, your tie is very beautiful. Some people might be seeing the tie and be angry.
But they are pocket.
Unfortunately, they will come and tell you that they like your tie. They like you. God is short. Hallelujah. So in a season such as this, what we need is to pray. Somebody say, I will pray. And I want to tell someone in the house that our God remains prayer answering God. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want you to turn to someone by your side. Don't touch him. I didn't say hold. I said just turn. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just tell him you are blessed.
You are blessed.
In this season you are blessed.
In this season.
In the name of Jesus. You are already blessed by God. So you are uncastable. I just came back from America. Somebody was giving the testimony. I thank God. The flight to Dubai was turbulent, but God took control. I just came yesterday.
Which flight?
You see somebody, a big house flying in the air. They are saying it is not. And I was discussing with Bishop the other day. We have seen how useless the private jets of those that are buyers have become useless. If a nation did not get you to visit those nations for 4 months, a nation can live without you for 40 years.
Yes.
Let nobody hide under one finger and deceive me that I have a message to preach in America, and from there I go to England, and from there I go to where, and I have to now be in Nigeria for 4 months. Your private jets have been parked. Useless. You yourself have been tied on one spot. Did those nations eventually collapse? Anybody that tells you all those tears is in and lied every time. A lot of deception on the pulpit. The money they ought to spend to take care of the people of God, they gather from the people of God and waste it. But in your own case, I speak to you. You will experience this in Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, turn it to prayers. In Nigeria, I stand to receive peace. Peace unto Nigeria. Peace unto my household. Peace in my business. Peace in my endeavors. Peace. 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 Peace in the north of Nigeria. Peace in the south of Nigeria. Peace in the east of Nigeria. Peace. Peace in the west. Peace. Peace in my business. Peace in my home. Concerning my health. Peace. I declare it by the power of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' holy and mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Stretch your hands towards the altar. Irrespective of the killing around you, I declare peace in your household.
Amen.
I didn't say it. The Bible says it. God has said it. And He's the one that speaks. And no one can alter. He is God. He is God. He is God. He is God. Greater than all of us combined. He says, you shall see the good of Nigeria. I declare it to you, you will see the good of Nigeria. You will not see shame in Nigeria. You will not see sorrow in Nigeria. You will not see calamity in Nigeria. You will not see difficulty in Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. Thank you, Father. We briefly look through your word, speak unto us. And your name be glorified forever. In Jesus' holy and mighty name, we have prayed. Arise, we will take a representation of the business we do, and we talk to it. In Psalm 128 that we read in the call to worship, the first one of it, let us read together. One, two, go. Blessed is everyone that fear the Lord and walketh in His way. Verse 2.
For thou shalt be the labor of thy hand.
Happy shalt thou be, and you shall be well with thee. Now I want you to personify it. That particularly verse 2. 1, 2, 3, go. For
thou shalt be the labor of thy hand.
Happy shalt thou be, and you shall be well with thee. I want you to say it again to yourself. Because you see, this is the word of the Lord. See, it is only that which God has not spoken that can be altered. Who is he that said when God has not spoken? It is only that which God has not said that cannot come to pass. When God says it, it is only a matter of has not said it, it is not bound to happen.
Right.
But so long as he has said it, and you have discovered it, and you are claiming it, it's only a matter of time. It is coming to pass. Therefore, verse 2, say it loud to yourself.
I
shall be the labor of my hands. Happy shall I be. And shall be well with me. About anybody in life can succeed in business. But I also meant God to say that about anybody can lose in business. We've seen great businesses that eventually collapsed. Great financial institutions that eventually folded up. So about anyone in life can make it big time in business without knowing God, but about anybody can also experience a total collapse in business. But listen to me. When God is involved, somebody say, when God is involved. Say it louder, please. Say it louder. Let the devil hear us and be angry. Now listen, success is guaranteed. And success is not just guaranteed. Success is guaranteed consistently and sustainably. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because you have evolved the one that is sustainably consistent. I am the Lord. I change not. Nothing changes God. Coronavirus does not change God. He cannot die. He is above death. That is God. When you involve God in your endeavor, that endeavor is bound to succeed consistently and sustainably. I want you to face someone by your side and say, your success is not negotiable.
Your success is not negotiable.
You shall not fail in business. You shall not fail in business. The words of your hand will not fail. In the name of Jesus, I want you to first of all rise on your feet and say it loud to yourself. I refuse to fail in business.
I
refuse to struggle in business. Whatsoever I get my hands to do, I just succeed. In the name of Jesus. Turn into praise. I refuse to fail in business. I refuse to stop in business. I receive divine grace, divine backing, divine power to succeed in business. I shall not fail. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we are praying. Stretch your hands toward the altar. Your success in your business is not negotiable.
Amen.
It is guaranteed.
Amen.
Therefore, I speak to your life. You shall not fail in business.
Amen.
You shall not struggle in business.
Amen.
If you believe it, shout to the powerful amen.
Amen.
Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord. So to ensure guaranteed success in business, fear God. In everything you do, it is always good for you to understand the principle that backs it up. This microphone is not just working. There is a principle backing it up. The keyboard is not just working. There is a principle that backs it up. I may not be concerned with the way that what I'm saying now is transmitted to you via the electronic system. From here, it doesn't just come to the speakers. It moves here, is connected to the console before it is further connected to the speaker. I may not be concerned with the science behind it, but those that have understood the principle and they are making it to work are those that have manufactured it and they are making money from people like me, who do not understand the principle with which it is working. That is the way life is. If you understand the principle of a thing and you engage that principle, life opens for you. You become successful. The principle of success in business is, blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord. So, to ensure a guaranteed success in that which you do, fear God. Fear God. Fear God. Because in that verse 1, it said, when you fear God, you are blessed. When you fear God, it is not to the advantage of God, it is to the advantage of you. It is already said before you were born. All you need to do is to understand the principle, work with it, make use of it, and then you get the result. You want to succeed in business sustainably, consistently. The Bible says, fear God. Fear God. Fear God. Why? If you fear God, you will be blessed. And the Bible says it is the blessing of God that makes rich. And it adds no sorrow. It didn't say not, it didn't say your certificate. That is not to say your certificate is useless. It didn't say who you know. That is not to say that who you know is useless. But let me tell you, those things are limited. You can acquire the best of certificates. And one old woman in the village can capture the certificate and lock it inside a pot. And now begin to live like somebody who never obtained a certificate. That is the limit or the limitation of such. You can know people, but one old woman in the village can decide to get you, get the person that you know. Inside the pot, I've told you this story before. It was not told to me directly. But, in other words, I didn't know the fellow that it happened to. But somebody that knew somebody that it happened to was the one that related the story. A young man from a state, Iluama Alijo, Alijo your state, I don't want to mention, but you know your state now. Somebody shout hallelujah. So he lives in Lagos. God is blessing him. Well married, have children, had a house of his own, and he had a car. And so what did he do? He wanted to pretend. And so he went to the village in a public transport. And when he got there, he met an old man that said, oh, you are welcome. You know those people, they don't speak English. As a matter of fact, they don't speak Yoruba. They speak in their local tongue. Somebody shout hallelujah. And then I said to him, where are your children? He said, they are fine. Where is your car? And the man was saying that he does not have a car. Where the woman saw that he was arguing, as I was told in the story, the woman said, come follow me. Took him to a dark room, opened a pot, and then look at it. What did he see inside the pot? He saw his children, he saw his house, he saw his wife, he saw his children riding bicycle. If you came from the village where I come from, you will know that there are certain realities. So certificates can be gained. Strategies can be gained. Have you not seen people? They understand something so well. To the extent that when they give advice or counsel or consult for other people. Those other people they consult for make it in that business. But when they on their own go to execute it, they fail. When we were still writing back in days, I know people that before the exam, they will teach us all those calculus, all those, what again? Not, was it calculus? No. It was later we did calculus in our institution. All those longitude and latitude, simultaneous equation, quadratic equation. They know all the almighty formula and the one that is the mighty formula. They know everything. There's some of us that they teach, go to write quiet, we add distinction. But listen to me. When God's blessing goes ahead of you, in whatsoever you do, a colorful and enviable result awaits you. I speak to your life. God will bless you. Blessed is everyone that fear the Lord. When God blesses you, your business becomes uncursable. I'm not afraid of any witch. I lead my life because I know that you cannot curse me and stand. If God has already blessed me, it means that God has spoken concerning me before you. Whatsoever you have to say is immaterial. God has spoken, and that is bound to happen. In your life, you will see the blessing of God. He said, behold, in Job chapter 28, verse 28, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom. And to depart from evil is understanding. Now, listen. When you fear the Lord, he says, you will be blessed. And he said, the blessing of the Lord maketh rich, and it adds no sorrow. Which suggests that, and the Bible also says, that the fear of the Lord is wisdom. So what eventually will make you become rich as you fear the Lord is that you will be wise. I've been in business. By the grace of God, I can count consistently 23 years. I've seen prosperity. I've gathered, I've lost everything. There is no wise man that loses his business. If you operate by the wisdom of God, you can never lose. If you look at every accident that occurs, there is always a mistake. For every business that fails, there is always a mistake. And what do I call mistake? Things that you ought to do that you do not do. Or things that you ought to do, or things that you did that you are not supposed to do. That is what this is called. What is wisdom? You move at the right time, you talk at the right time, you act at the right time, you are thinking right, that is wisdom. How to generate it is by the fear of the Lord. That is what the scripture is saying. What makes people fail in business is stupid acts. Wrong steps, wrong decisions, delayed decision, hasty decisions. Every business you want to do is attached to your age. There are businesses you cannot afford to do when you have surpassed a certain age bracket because you might not have the strength and the capability to push through. Business has got to do with time. If you fail to act when you ought to act, and the moment the time has gone past, if you now begin to act, because you have been foolish and stupid,
all about you seeing the opportunity and arising to time to take it. It will require wisdom to do that. So when you walk in the fear of God, my conclusion is that you will be wisely blessed. And if you are blessed, the labor of your hand is bound to be fruitful. No devil can give up. No force of darkness can overcome you. That is why I am saying to your life, if I can build from just only one person, my younger sister, to eventually gather more than 350 people, that was business that is small today is becoming a city.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Every big business you see today was started by only one person.
Yeah.
Unilever is Deliver's brothers. Procter and Gamble, two friends that came together. Microsoft, Bill Gates, and Allen, what? Tallest. Where is Tallest? Bill Gates. And who? And then what? Olodoro Ejo. Eh? I've forgotten the second part. Facebook was started by who? Who? Zuckerberg and who? Ali? Zuckerberg! That's it. Today, do you know that Facebook is no longer a city? As a matter of fact, it's bigger than a continent. That's for small business is becoming a city. Your amen is too lazy. May you get it according to your amen.
God. So learn to engage God.
calling him daddy. We are still calling him God. We are still calling him Jehovah. But what we are doing is we have gone ahead. And I said, daddy, please let us go. That is how idiotic many of us behave. That is how stupid most of us are. You want to do something, you leave God out of it. You never allow him to be the guide. No, God should move and you follow. You should search his way, see his way, and simply follow. Where he's leading you, you don't know, but he knows where he's leading you. Why he's leading you that way, you don't know, but he knows why he's leading you. That is how to succeed in business. Your business will not fail.
Amen.
I say your business will not fail.
Amen.
Some people are too knowledgeable than God. So stop leading yourself. Subdue your reasoning under God. Stop being full of yourself. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Some of us are too independent. We are too dependent on ourselves. Stop being dependent on yourself. Start depending on God. Don't go and be desiring a height and now begin to engage God to support you so as to attain the height that you are desirous of. Let God be the one dictating the height.